Hi everyone, my name is Luba. Welcome to Orgasmic Life channel. And today I'm going to talk about orgasmic birth. For those who doesn't know, I am pregnant a little bit more than 8 months. The little one has a nickname, it's Mini Mishka. And talking about orgasmic birth, how I came to this. So I remember looking backwards, I always knew that I will get pregnant, I will have kids. It's something that I always wanted. What was devastating for me, how I'm going to give a birth. What I heard from women around me, that it's super painful, it's terrifying, that you will quickly forget, but this moment is just so crazy. And then just thinking that this baby head should go out of me, how it will happen. So all of this, I was just super afraid. And then when I knew that I'm pregnant, from that moment I had to face it. And what I realized, that there are people, there are women, who actually describe birth as a pleasurable, amazing, empowering experience. And they were saying that, oh, I felt very strong sensations, but I can't call it pain. I realized that, okay, on some reason I was surrounded by women who didn't have amazing birth experience. What if I change it? So I started, like, during this, the whole pregnancy period, I did so much reading, watching videos, movies, meeting with women, joining communities, and I really put a lot of work into just switching my subconscious and looking at birth like at something that that is amazing. And this is the book I came around. It's called Orgasmic Birth, and I loved it so much that usually I don't like reading, I prefer listening to books. This one is not available in audio, so I read it like almost in 1 week. I just nailed it. I completely read it. And I'm going to tell you my takeaways from this book. So the first one, like important things to look at, that what if we compare birth to sex? How to have more possibility, like to have a pleasurable, amazing, like really good, sexy, yummy experience? It has to be privacy. So most likely it has to be partners who participate in sex, no one else. We don't have like people moving around. It has to be at home probably, or in some like interesting lights, like some people like dark, people like candles, candlelight, or red light lamps. When we create this private, yummy, nice environment, most likely we'll be able to relax and have amazing, great sex. Same with birth. We need that environment to be able to relax. So I realized that I really want to do it at home. I found a midwife who will come and assist us in the whole process. We are going to rent a birthing tub. I have this idea to give birth in water. There is something super cool about it. And of course, a lot of candles and just creating. I'm going to have this cozy, amazing experience, very similar to when I'm having sex, and what makes me enjoy sex, the similar scene will make me to enjoy birth. The next scene that I got from this book, they really encourage us to look at animals, like cats, who has cats at home. And if you ever experienced, I didn't have such chance, but I was reading about it, that when a cat given a birth, you never see a cat who will be like screaming in so much pain. They just get quiet, they get again in the dark, some like dark spot where they can relax, and they just quietly produce those kittens. The question is why women can't do that. Of course we can. So animals are our little cute teachers that we could learn from them as well. And the final scene, fear is the biggest enemy. When a woman is afraid of contractions of the birth, and then contraction starts, then we feel super scared, like the body is tense, and we start like producing adrenaline, which makes it like feel so painful. That's the reason of why it is painful in many cases. The opposite, when we relax and we surrender, and when we are not afraid, the contraction came and we are like, oh my God, baby is on the way. It's amazing. Yes, 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 Mini Mishka, you're coming. And then when I just welcome it and I understand, oh, baby is coming, let me just relax and help the baby, the nature, do their thing. And then oxytocin produced instead of adrenaline. And oxytocin brings us this pleasurable, euphorical feeling when we are just like flying and having this ecstasy feeling. Baby just, like, everything happens so differently. Just important not to be afraid. I managed to bring myself from being so fearful to now I'm so anticipated, I can't wait, I want to have this birth experience so much. And when I say it to my midwife, she's like, don't rush, let baby take their time, don't hurry up, like the right time baby will come. And I'm so ready and so excited and so looking forward to that. And this is how I feel right now, how I'm preparing. I don't know how it will happen. I will tell you later. Trust me, I will tell you honestly whatever happened. So we will see. I want to ask women who had some of those amazing experiences, please write in comments and share. I need this encouragement right now. It's coming up so soon. And at the same time, I want to request from those who had really traumatic and not so cool experience, please hold on for now and don't share it. I really, really working hard to put, like, to keep my subconscious into all this approach that birth is so amazing and so wonderful. Thank you for listening. I can't wait to hear from you. And please stay on the channel if you like it, and I will see you later. Bye-bye.